Charlie, SorterSurvival.com. On today's episode, I'm going to show you how to make your own glue from the materials you find in the wilderness. It's called pine pitch or pine glue. I have behind me a station set up. I got a little fire going to heat the materials, and I'll go ahead and show you what materials we need for this. Okay, first thing you're going to want to get is some pine pitch. This is rosin that comes out of the wounds of pine trees and everything. Every time a limb breaks off or the tree gets injured in some way, the sap comes running out to cover up and protect the wound. Now, this is also a good source first aid thing for you, because the rosin prevents the growth of bacteria and germs and stuff like that, which protects the tree. If you get a cut or something, you don't have a band-aid, you can go to a pine tree, and the fresh sap that's coming out. Also, you can use pinon tree too, and rub it, take some of that and rub it on there, and then cover it with a piece of cloth or something. But you're going to need a good chunk of this, enough to do what you're going to plan on using it for. I'm not going to use much, so all I need is one part, or this is going to be my five parts to one part of my other two materials. The other two materials I'm using is, you're going to need charcoal from your wood fire. And you're also going to need fine plant material. Now, instead of going out and having to chop up your materials and everything, you can go ahead and go out and find you some of these things right here. All that is rabbit poop pellets, or whatever you want to call it. And the reason you want to use that is because once the rabbit eats it, he's already processed it for you. So it saves you some work, and all you got to do is grind it up into a fine powder like this. So this is already one part of your plant material, and I've also went ahead and ground it up one part of your the charcoal. It needs to be real fine. So I'm going to go ahead and get my station back set up back here now. I'm going to show you what we're going to do next. Okay, next thing you're going to need is something to melt the pitch and mix everything. And I'm using old tin from a boot polishing setup. And you're going to need something to hold it with, so I'm using my multi-tool. So what you're going to need to do is go ahead and put your pine material, your rosin, into here and set it next to the fire. So it'll start melting. Now, you don't really need a very big fire for this, and you gotta be careful, because that pine pitch will catch on fire also at a certain point. And all you gotta do is just cover it with something over top of it to put it out. Pitch is already burning. Make sure you get you a little stick or twig or something that you can use to stir with. Now, the pitch I don't want to burn, I just want it to melt. I've caught on fire again. Stop it. But once my coals burn down a little bit, I can sit around on top of the coals, and it'll do the job for me. So what I'm going to do to save space on my video is, I'm going to go ahead and pause the video for a minute, and then once my material melts, I'll show you adding the other stuff. Okay, I just want to show you there how it looks after it's boiled. I haven't mixed the ingredients yet, so I'm going to go ahead and do that now. This stuff dries quick, so you have to work kind of fast with it. Add my one part rabbit scat, where it actually is your plant material, and then one part charcoal. that, you mix it up really good. Stuff really hot. Ooh. Okay, that's pretty well mixed up. Now if you're wondering what I'm going to use this for, is I'm in the process of making a throwing arrow or a throwing spear, better known as an atlatl, and I'm using the yucca stalk. Since I can't find one long enough that's straight enough, I took two that's straight and I notched them like this, cutting a notch so I can put them together. What I'm going to do is I'm going to put some pine pitch glue there, put them together, and bind my cordage. Next thing I'm going to do is, since I'm using a metal tip for this arrow and I don't want it sliding out, I'm going to put some pitch on that and stick it in there as well. So first thing I'm going to do is a tip first. Yeah. Take and coat it really well. Now since this stuff dries really fast, I'm gonna put it in the fire and heat it up just a little bit. Then I'm gonna stick it down in here before it dries completely. Like that. So I actually got some glue, pine pitch wedged down into the tip. Now while that's drying, later on I'll put my string on. Next, what I want to do is I want to get my cordage ready for shafting my two shafts together. I'm going to put a slip knot in it so that when I tighten it up, when I put my glue on there, I can go ahead and tighten both of them up, try to hold them together. Sometimes this gets a little difficult trying to do this and keep it in the camera at the same time. Okay, here's some of this glue. Get it on there. Watch, nice and hot. Okay, as you can see, I have it on there. And since this stuff dries really quick, you don't really want to play around too much. Just take and go ahead and put your two shafts together. Take your cordage. Where you had your slip knot. Stick them together, make sure they're even. And go ahead and tighten down on that while it's drying. That's stuck already. I can't get it apart. That stuff's pretty good. Get back in there. Okay, what I'm going to do, since I broke the seal on it, I'm going to have to put some more on there. Alright. You want this to get it to where you want it before it sets, or Once you break the seal, then you just defeated your purpose. Okay, tighten that up. Okay, that'll hold it in place while it's completely drying. Okay, I'm gonna set that down and let it dry. Then what I'm gonna do is go ahead and stop the tape, go ahead and finish my lashings, and then show you what I'm gonna do with the glue after that. Okay, I'm back. What I'm doing next is getting some more for my pine pitch. And everywhere I tied this, I'm gonna put some pine pitch there. You can actually cover all the strings too to keep them from slipping. But I'm running out of pine pitch, I don't have enough. But everywhere I've tied this, I want to put some of that pine pitch on there. And just smooth it out a little bit. But this stuff, it dries quick, and you gotta really work with it fast. I'm putting some around the sides of the blade, keep the blade from moving around. Ouch. Put there in the strings, put down in the cracks, everywhere it goes, and then kinda, ouch, ouch. Smooth it out. But this is almost all used up, so if you had some left over, you can still let it dry and put the top on it, and later on you can use the same stuff, just heat it up if you have enough for something else. But basically, here's the tip of my throwing spear, the atlatl, which I'm hoping, if I were to use it to for wild pig, javelina, small deer, or whatever. Okay, like I said, I hafted two straight shafts together because I couldn't find one long. This one still has to be modified a little bit. Step back a little bit so you can see what I'm, get a full picture here without burning myself. But as you can see, it's probably about 5 foot tall, and later on may cut it down to the length I need it for throwing. I still have to make the handle for it and put some feathers on it, but I'm going to use this to continue on with a different post. So you'll be seeing this again in the near future. So this is Charlie, SwordOfSurvival.com. You just saw a way of making improvised glue, Mother Nature's glue. On the post I will put different other type of materials you can use for the same thing, but you get the basic idea of what to use this for. Again, I can't even break it off the end, so there you go. But it's really good, holds on quick. But hopefully you learn to get a good use out of this glue if you need to. You can also use it, like say if you have a tarp tent or something that's got a cut down through the middle of it, you can make some of this glue, find you a patch, put some glue in that patch and stick it on that hole real quick, and you can mend it. You can also mend clothing with it, you name, whatever you can find uses for glue, you can use this. So this is Charlie, SwordOfSurvival.com. Come back soon. Stay prepared, stay alive.